In this video, I'll show you how to create a GitHub action that will run your unit test. Ideally, you would run your unit test before you try to push your changes to GitHub, but we're all human and sometimes we forget and just push our changes to the repository. This way, by creating the GitHub action, GitHub will always run the unit test for us. I'll start with the demo app that I created for the unit test video. This is a simple application. We just have one math function class here with an add numbers function. And we have one unit test here that checks to make sure if we pass in a 2 and a 4, we get a 6 back. If we pass in a 3 and a 4, we get a 7 back. And I'll also mention that the front end for this is a console application in .NET 6. I've already created a repository in GitHub for this solution and push the code in there. To add the action, you'll go into the repository and look for the actions button up here. Click on that, and GitHub has several actions that are fairly typical, and it even looks at your code to figure out what sort of actions might be the best one here. It suggests for this solution we can either do this .NET action, which builds and tests a .NET or ASP.NET core project, or we can do .NET desktop. This builds the solution, runs our unit test, signs it, publishes it, and puts out a copy of the executable for someone to potentially download. For this, I'm going to do the simple one. All we want to do is make sure that when we push any changes, our unit tests get run. So we're going to do this .NET action. Click on the configure. And here we see the .NET.YML. This contains the specifications for the build action. It looks for pushes and pull requests on the master branch, and it tells you what jobs to run. In this case, the job is going to be build, and beneath the build, we have the information for the build job. The first thing we have on line 12 is the runs on value, and this says Ubuntu-latest. Since this is a .NET 6 console application, it is cross-platform, so I can build this on Ubuntu. If this was a .NET 6 WPF application, or if this was a .NET framework application or a Windows Form application, I could not build it on Ubuntu. So I would have to change runs on from Ubuntu latest to Windows latest. If you aren't sure which option to choose, Windows latest is probably the safest, because you can still build .NET Core console application in Windows, but you can't build a .NET framework or a WPF application in the Ubuntu. I'm going to change this back to Ubuntu just because this is a .NET 6 console application. I might as well use the lighter weight solution. And the other thing that's important is down on line 19, the .NET version. I'm going to change this to 6.0.x since this is a .NET 6 application. If you were using .NET 5, you would have to put in 5.0. If you're using a specific version of .NET framework, you'd have to put in that here. This also on line 21 does a .NET restore, so this will restore any dependencies in the project, which includes any NuGet packages. Then on line 22 and 23, we have our build. We're going to do the .NET build. And then on lines 24 and 25, we have .NET test. This is the step that runs the unit test in our solution. There are a lot more steps you can do, a lot more options you can set up in your YAML file, but this does the basic build and run our unit test that we want whenever we commit any code and try to push it into the repository. So what I'll do now that I have the YAML file set up the way I want, I'll click Start Commit. And this is creating another file that gets added to our repository. So since we have to add this .NET.YML to our repository, we have to commit the change of creating this YAML file and including it in the repository. I'm going to say here, commit directly to the master branch, since this is a personal project and I can commit directly to the master branch, and click commit new file. Now we see it's part of our demo app repository under the GitHub folder. We have a workflows folder, and here's the .NET.YML, the steps for doing our action. If I go back into my solution, go to my Git changes, since I'm on the master branch where we put in the YML file, I can do pull, and this pulls down the YAML file. So if we go into our directory, I go to my public projects, demo app, I now have this .github directory with a workflows folder and the .net.yml. So I can change it directly in here now. If I go back to my page here in GitHub and go into the actions, we see one workflow run. So when I added that and I committed that change of adding in the YML file, it now executed the GitHub action we created, since the action said anytime you commit to the master branch, do this action. And we see a green checkbox here. So that means the YAML file that we created with our instructions for the build and running the unit test, everything passed. If something didn't pass, we'd have a red X here, and we could look at the details of the error. So now let's test how this would actually work in real changes. I'm going to go into my code, go into the math functions, and on my return A plus B, I'm going to switch that to return A minus B. This obviously is not going to add numbers, it's going to subtract numbers, but I want to show you what happens when something breaks. So now I want to commit this, and I'm going to say new change and commit and push. So this will push this change to GitHub. The GitHub action will detect that a change has been pushed to the master branch, and it will run that GitHub action. So we do the commit and push, go back to GitHub, and let's refresh our actions page. So now we see new change. This is the change that I just committed. And I've got a little yellow circle here, which means it's running. Since this is a small application and a small action, this should be fairly quick. And we see a red X now that it's done. That's because the unit test failed. The change that I made broke the unit test. I can click on the new change here, click on the build, and now I see the details of the build. The setup job worked fine, setup.net, restoring the dependencies, building all worked fine, no errors in here, but when it ran the unit test, here's the information that said, for this unit test, we expected a 6 and we got a minus 2, so the test failed. I'll just go back to our actions. So now I know something broke. If I go back to the code, change this back to an A plus B, put in a message of fixed, and do a commit all and push, we can go back to our actions. I'll refresh it. We see that my fixed changes are now being run through the action. And we're back to a green check mark because the code now works again and our unit test passed again. There's a lot more you can do with the actions to make them a lot smarter, but this is kind of some of the basic steps of setting up your first GitHub action and making sure that it reports on whether your changes broke the unit test or not. If you have any questions about this, please leave a comment beneath the video and I'll get back to you as soon as possible.